Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
I'm still getting set up here because I was juggling two wonderful things, a fantastic study session in the Beit Midrash led by Chris on the Hadodi, so yashar koch, beautifully done, and visiting with Rabbi Gabi Dagan, who is here from Haifa. We're thrilled he's with us and recognize the sacrifice and the pull you've made by sticking around. I called him on Tuesday, and I said, will you still be here on Friday? And he said, I certainly hope so. And I'm glad you can be with us on Shabbat, even though our hearts in many ways are over in Haifa as well. So we'll hear from Rabbi Dagan later in our service. Lots to celebrate in a busy, busy, busy week. So I hope we can take our time to just step back from the world a little bit and express our deepest desires and express the deepest sense of gratitude for the good things in life as well. But before we do, let's say hello to the people around us, introduce ourselves, and then we'll begin.
Hello, Matan. I'm Cantor Shana. I'm coming to say hi to my For a few weeks this summer, we have been learning a new melody that I'd like to bring back tonight. Perhaps it's familiar to some of you, for others it might be new, but the words are simple. They are Kol HaNeshama Tehalelia, all living things that breathe, all breathing things can praise God. So let's try this melody together a few times until it feels like yours. Kol HaNeshama Neshama, te hallelia, hallelujah. Ilan's gonna help me with this. Kol ha neshama, te hallelia, hallelujah. Goes up, yeah. Let's try that again. Kol ha neshama, te hallelia. Hallelujah. Kol HaNeshama Tehallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, like this. Together, Kol HaNeshama,
kol haneshama tehalleluya, halleluya.
Every living thing,
kol haneshama tehalleluya, halleluya,
halleluya. Here we go.
To invite you to light our candles for us this evening. So, anyone been to Israel in the past year? It's been a difficult year, but I know there are some people who have. So please come forward. Gabby, you count. Deborah, will you light candles on behalf of everyone? And some are about to go to Israel very soon.
Let's join together.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Vitsivanu lehadligne, lehadligne shel shalom.
Amen. Page 130, Lechuna Ranana, we sing.
And in the spirit of rejoicing together, I've asked our normal pianist, Ilan, to play an elevated role tonight. So you might hear his voice a little bit more. This is still a summer service, and we're playing around a little bit.
Come,
let us rejoice together from the Book of Psalms. Let us come into God's presence.
I've asked our student Abby Scott, who is in 9 days, she says, heading off to Emory to begin her journey at college. And so for her last Shabbat at home, we thought maybe she would help us lead Lecha Dodi and a few of our other prayers. So let's join together. Words greeting the Sabbath bride, beginning on page 138, are on our screens.
Shamor v'zachor b'diburecha Hishmianu el hamiyuchad.
Keep and remember a single command.
Adonai echad u'shemo echad.
God is one.
L'shem u'tiferet v'liti. Love. Baruch Adonai HaMevorach Le'olam Va'ed Le'olam Va'ed Yalla lay 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 Yalla lay 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 Yalla lay lay
Continue on page 150, thinking of the love that God has shown all of us through giving us Torah on this Shabbat Devarim as we move into the final of our five books before we repeat the cycle as we have for thousands of years. Together as one, Shema, page 152.
Shema, Israel, Adonai,
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha bechol levavcha uvechol nafshecha uvechol meodecha ve'hayu hadevarim ha'ele asher anochi mitzavecha hayom alevavecha Vishinantam levanecha vidibartabam beshivtecha bevetecha uvlechtecha vaderech uvshochbecha uvkumecha ukshartam leot al yadecha v'hayu letotafot b'neinecha uchtavtam al mezuzot b'techa uvisharecha leman tizkeru vasitem et kol mitzvotai v'item kedoshim leloechem Ani Adonai Elohechem, Asher hotzeiti etchem, Meretz Mitzrayim, Liot lachem l'Elohim. Ani Adonai Elohechem, Adonai Elohechem, Amen. Song of Redemption, page 158.
We encourage you to find your voice in the sounds of the sea and the sounds of this room as we do a call and response approach to our Micha Mocha.
Micha Mocha, Micha Mocha, Ba'elim Adonai, Ba'elim Adonai, Micha Mocha, Micha Mocha, Nedar Ba'Kodesh, Nedar Ba'Kodesh.
Dagan is visiting us from Haifa. This is not a formal introduction, for many of you know him. However, It's really special to be able to lead the Hashkiveinu in prayer with you tonight. We learned from Rabbi Sapphire a few weeks back that music can really be a vehicle for peace. And you being here tonight and singing with us reminds us that there is hope for peace. So let's pray together. Let there be love. Let's hear every voice from the deepest parts of your soul singing loudly with us tonight. We also want to bring your attention to a new section of this prayer that Ilan and I will lead you through. The words can be found on the screens. We hope they bring you meaning and intention as we prepare to pray.
Adonai, Sivatai Tifta.
Will you hear our prayer?
tifta. Fiagid tehilatecha baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu ve'Elohei avoteinu ve'imoteinu Elohei Avraham Elohei Yitzchak ve'Elohei Yaakov Elohei Sarah Elohei Rivka Elohei Rachel ve'Elohei Leah Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor ve'Hanora El Elyon Gomel Chasadim Tovim ve'Konei Hakol V'zocher chastei avot v'imahot U'mivi ge'ula libnei b'neihem L'ma'an shemo be'ahava Melech ozer u'moshia u'magein Baruch atah Adonai Magein Avraham ve'ezrat Sarah Ata gibor le'olam Adonai Mechaye hakol ata rab lehoshia Morid hata Mechakel chayim bechesed Mechaye hakol berachamim rabim Somech naflim berofe cholim Surim umekayem emunato lishenei afar micha mocha ba'al gevurot umidam elach melech meimit unechaye umatzmiach yeshua Ve'ne'emanata l'achayot hakol Baruch atah Adonai Mechaye hakol Atah kadosh v'shimcha kadosh U'kdoshim b'chol yom yalelu chasela Baruch atah Adonai Ha'el
own personal prayers. You can be seated when you've finished. Last week, we marked 300 days since October 7th, and all week, I've been surprised by the three in that first digit. It's unbelievable that we're still counting, and every Shabbat, we pray that this will be the last Shabbat, that we count the last Shabbat, that we pray for an end to this war, the end, return of the hostages, and we continue to pray until we have a reason not to. So we'll join together in the words on the screen. Sovereign of all the world, shelter Israel beneath your protective presence. May all its inhabitants and defenders know physical and psychological safety. May they find strength in solidarity and be nourished by our love and support. Guide us with wisdom and compassion as we balance the necessity of Israel's safety, security, with the suffering of all those who are innocent in Gaza. At this time of danger and grief, may we have the audacity to pray for peace, just as our ancestors have done each time they were threatened and terrorized. We pray that the people of Israel find wholeness and know tranquility. We pray for shalom in the land we love.
Bring peace. Bring love. Bring peace. Bring love. Oh, say shalom bimroma.
To these prayers of hope, prayers for healing for those in our world who are in need. And so if there's someone you're thinking about this Shabbat, we'd invite you to rise so we can come around and share in those names with you. That they all find moments of healing, if not complete healing, in this week to come. The words of Misha Berach.
Misha Berach.
Sydney is crying out for her Hebrew name, but before we call her up with her parents and her brother, I want to give us the opportunity to share those sacred moments in life perhaps you've shared during the past week. Birthdays, celebrations, God-given times. Anyone? Please, Louise. Say that again.
My birthday was on Wednesday.
Your birthday. Happy birthday from Wednesday. Happy birthday.
Yeah, my brother. Upstairs.
Please. Another birthday, son.
Rabbi,
yes.
I just want to say happy birthday to my brother yesterday, and or 2 days ago, and my sister-in-law today on
Great.
Zoom.
Great, on Zoom, a birthday. Steve. Wonderful.
Yes, thank you.
Anyone else?
One of my lacrosse teams, we're going for the gold medal round this Wednesday.
Celebration of the... So, many things to celebrate, but the celebration of... A young child entering into the covenant between God and the Jewish people is a communal celebration. And so it is a great joy to call upon members of our Gan Elohim community. And so I'd like to call upon Sydney Page with her parents, Lindsay and Brian, and her brother Parker. Correct?
Yes, that's Parker.
We're all going to come up. I want to welcome your families, your parents, the whole mishpucha who's here. Mazel tov, everybody. We're thrilled to welcome your family to Temple Beth Elohim and to welcome Sydney into the coven on her second birthday. Is that right?
Second birthday.
It just...
Wow.
So mazel tov. 2 years old. Lovely two. Here we go. So before Sydney receives her Hebrew name, I have asked her parents to share a brief word about the names they've selected. I know they hold great meaning. Right in here.
Thank you. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
I'm Lindsay. This is my husband, Brian, my daughter, Sydney, my son, Parker. We're so grateful to share Sydney's baby naming with you. This is a really especially exciting Shabbat because it's Sydney's birthday today, and she's very excited to be two. Sydney's Hebrew name is Livia Bela, and it's in honor of Brian's great-grandmother, Lydia Rawson, my great-grandmother, Beatrice Miller, and my grandmother, Betty Bloomberg. Livia means lioness, and Bela means beautiful in Hebrew. We admire the combination of these traits as we imagine Sydney will grow to be a fierce and brave protector. We would love to share a little bit about these three women that Sydney is named for. My great-grandmother Bea was born in 1913 and lived in Providence and Barrington, Rhode Island throughout her life. Bea attended Pembroke College, which later merged with Brown University. She married my grandfather Meyer and had two children, Carol Ann and Donald. B Bea absolutely loved to read. She could easily read a book or two per night, which included a ritual of Entenmann's chocolate cake and coffee milk. At breakfast, she was always surrounded by various newspapers and carefully sorted and clipped coupons. It was on any given day that I would receive an envelope with a pile of coupons in a paperclip from her. She was a master bridge player and loved a good jigsaw puzzle. A shrewd businesswoman, Bea was independent and sharp as a tack. She lived the remarkable age of 101 years old. Sydney is also named for my paternal grandmother, Betty Bloomberg. Betty was born in Indianapolis and later moved to Boston and married my grandfather, Goody. Betty had exquisite taste. Her homes were filled with incredible art, antiques, and pieces from her worldly travels. When she was not in Brookline, Betty split her time between Palm Beach and Nantucket. She was adored by her friends, loved shopping, social events, playing tennis, and canasta. It was never too early for cocktail hour, and Betty loved a good martini. Betty adored me, and spending time with her was always a confidence booster. She showered me with compliments and introduced me proudly to her friends. At times, when I approached her for advice, Betty had no interest in hearing about any bad news. She always focused on the positive, having fun, and living life to the fullest.
My great-grandmother, Lydia, who we called Nana Lydia,
was a tremendous person as well. She grew up in Boston and worked at her father's hat shop. And she was a hand model in the department store Filene's. She visited a friend in Detroit one weekend and attended a Jewish dance where she met my great-grandfather, William. My great-grandfather had immigrated from Russia by himself when he was 13, and he immediately fell in love with my Nana Lydia. Naturally, her parents did not like my great-grandfather, but luckily for us, she did. My father was extremely close with Nana Lydia. She was the best of both worlds, old-fashioned, but also modern. My father remembers that she would make homemade chopped liver and gefilte fish by hand. Shabbos dinners were an elaborate festival that my whole family looked forward to. At the same time, she was modern. She dressed to the nines and was a wonderful dancer and was the life of the party. She also had a very cool car when my dad was growing up, a Chevy Impala with bucket seats. It sounds odd, but my dad would borrow his grandmother's car to be cool and show off to his friends. When my parents moved from Michigan to Massachusetts when I was a young boy, Nana Lydia gave my family Shabbat candlesticks that her mother had given her, and they were manufactured in the 1800s. My dad was polishing them when he discovered they were made by Samuel Eastman, a company that, believe it or not, he was working for at the time. We had come full circle, and when we light the candles on Shabbat, we know that Nana Lydia is looking after us. We are very proud of Sydney, and she brings us so much joy. Her name, Livia Bela, will connect her with these wonderful qualities of her grandparents.
Beautifully said.
Thank you.
So, now we present her with her Hebrew name, Eloheinu v'Elohei Avotenu, v'Imotenu, Kayem etz ha'yalda hazot la'aviha u'le'ima. O God, God of our forefathers and foremothers, grant this child her Hebrew name, her name being Livia Bela, but your Hebrew name?
Beryl.
Beryl V, it's not on here. We've got to get it on here. Do you remember your Hebrew name?
Mayira Simcha.
Mayira Simcha. I just noticed we're going to change the certificate. Beryl V Mayira Simcha. Yismacha v'yotzitz chalatza v'tagel ima b'fri bitna. And may her name be a source of joy to her and to her family and bring holiness to all humankind. Zot ha'ketana gedola tiyeh. Keshem shenichnas nichnisa la brit kintikanes la Torah ulechupa ulemasim tovim,
And just on this evening, as her parents have brought her into the covenant between God and the Jewish people, may they bring her into a life of Torah, of study of our ethics and our values, a life of chuppah, a life, God willing, celebrated under the chuppah one day, of a loving relationship, and a life of ma'asim tovim, of good deeds. And let us all say,
amen.
Parker, her brother, has been waiting to present her with a very special gift. Parker, would you like to give your sister that beautiful picture that you made?
Parker, do you have anything to say to Sydney?
Thank you.
Say you love her?
You are a great big brother by presenting this gift.
Do you have anything you
say,
want to say?
I love you? Okay.
Can I show everyone?
Beautiful.
And then from TBE, maybe Parker, you can hold our Temple Beth Elohim bunny as we as a community ask for God's blessing upon her on this day. I threw out my back this morning. You want to give a hold?
Sydney, can I give you all a little hug and give you a blessing? Is that okay?
So after the threefold benediction, let's say, Ken Yehiratzon after each verse. As we, as a community, maybe not.
I'm going to just put my hand on your back. Is that okay? I'll give you a nice
little
back rub.
Bless Sydney. So.
Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha.
Ken Yehiratzon. May God bless you and protect you.
Ya'er Adonai panav elecha v'chunecha.
Ken Yehiratzon. May God shine down upon you and be gracious to you.
Yisa Adonai panav elecha v'yasem lecha shalom.
Let us all say, Ken Yehiratzon, may you always feel the love and support of your family and your community, and may God bless you with a life of wholeness, of shalom, of peace. And let us all say,
amen.
For the gift of life, for family, for tradition, for birthdays, let us give thanks to God with words of Shehechiyanu together.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu, melech ha'olam. Shehecheyanu v'kirmanu v'higiyanu lazman hazeh. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu, melech ha'olam. Shehecheyanu v'kirmanu v'higiyanu lazman.
I'm going to give a very brief introduction because the hour is late and some of us are going to remain to learn and have conversation with Rabbi Gabi afterwards in the social hall. But I just want to say we're thrilled you're with us, especially during these hours and dark days. And I just want you to know, since October 7th, we as a community have been thinking of Or Chadash continually. And I know through the active WhatsApp chat and continued activities, our communities continue to grow stronger and stronger. And so I just want to thank all the volunteers that give, but I know also receive so much through this relationship. And on behalf of all of us, thank you for your leadership. So thanks for being here. If you'll share.
Even better.
Okay.
Shabbat shalom. It's so good to be here. It's so good to see all of you. My heart is in the east, yet I am here at the end of west. We were days before our local municipal election in Israel. In the midst of raging protests against the government-planned judicial revolution that will potentially change the face of Israel. It was the center of our concerns. How little did we know? We were dancing at Or Hadash's Simchat Torah with local candidates, as Rabbi Nahma and myself were proud of the work we have done in making liberal Judaism important to our local politics, while having every single candidate at our shul wanting to take a picture with the Torah and with a male, but mostly with a female rabbi. We have done it, we thought. How little did we know? After dancing our feet off and saving strength for the next day's dancing, we went home to celebrate the holiday with our family. It was the 22nd day of Tishrei, October 6. We have all changed on October 7 on many levels. Our Israeli and Jewish existence have taken a turn. I grew up to believe this will never happen again to our Jewish people because we are strong. But it did, fiercely and brutally. How little did we know? We felt weak and exposed and helpless. We cried and mourned for weeks and months as the 7th of October became the Shiva of October, a very long Shiva. In the following chaotic days, we started getting news about our friends and families who had died as well as survived, a terminology we are using from different times in our history. 38 young adults of our community were immediately drafted, leaving their parents, wives, husbands, and children, and going to defend our country and bring home the hostages. We had many others serving in active duty, including my son. After not knowing how to hold the pain and the tears, we went on a doing mode, joining in with several organizations. On October 8, we cleared Or Hadash's parking lot and started putting tables and sending messages all around to bring basic equipment for families who lost everything. It soon expanded to soldiers and evacuees from the north. In a matter of days, our synagogue became one of the largest distribution centers of food, clothes, toys, blankets, water, batteries, military vests, and more. It was all dependent on the spirit of the people to replace what our country, what our government failed to provide at that time. The quiet road of Hantke 55 Street in Haifa became one of the busiest in the city. There's a story in the Talmud, in the book of Ta'anit, of fasting. The sages taught, when the temple was destroyed for the first time, many groups of young priests gathered together with the temple keys in their hands. And they ascended to the roof of the sanctuary and said before God, Master of the universe, since we did not merit to be faithful treasurers and the temple is being destroyed, let the temple keys be handed to you. And they threw them upwards, and a kind hand emerged and received the keys from them. This story is a story of despair and loss, but it's also a story of shared responsibility, acknowledgement, and reaching out. While we were all in our horrible, hopeless reality, you have reached out to us, holding our keys while we believed we are lost, supporting us while no one did, and holding them when it was and still is not an easy thing to do. The Messiah, the Mashiach, was born on the 9th of Av, according to tradition. On the day of destruction, hope was born, forcing us to hold impossible, conflicting realities at the same time. Israel, bring that complexity now more than ever. And in the midst of this horrible reality, you are still choosing us. You are choosing to encourage, visit, and support us in so many ways. Thank you. You have no idea how much strength it gives us to continue. Choosing us, for me, can be done by three things. The ability to embrace gvura, heroism. And heroism is measured mostly in times of hopelessness. The ability to love, and especially the ability to love others, just like Rabbi Akiva, when he saw, when he witnessed the destruction of the temple, he said, "Ve'ahavta le'reacha kamocha," you shall love your neighbor, your friend, as you love yourself. And the third is the ability to hold the future, the vision, and the hope. Reaching out to catch the keys thrown to the sky is, for me, an act of gvura, of love, and of hope. Gvura is about holding unpopular opinions about Israel while caring and worrying about us. This gvura is empowered by our partnership, our lifelong bond, love, and commitment to each other. We have spent hours, days, weeks, and years learning, reflecting, and understanding our connection and our role as Jews, as a people who share the same destiny, future, and hope. And we will continue, God's willing, to do that for years to come. I came here today to say thank you. Thank you for reaching out, for holding our hand, for embracing us with this complexity. Thank you. And may I add, Min ha-shamayim nenucham kulanu. Let us all be comforted from heaven. Shabbat shalom.
We're really happy you're here. And as you pick up the guitar,
I didn't mean to put him to work, but I did ask Rabbi Dagan to bring to us a piece of music that feels relevant and poignant right now, back in Haifa, in the land of Israel. And you might recognize this melody from a very popular video that was created by hundreds of Israelis that joined together in Caesarea by the Sea of Galilee in a huge amphitheater, where they joined together in communal song, words of Habaita, recognizing the madness of not being able to return home. So we think of the hostages. We pray for them to be returned home and safely and immediately.
Od shana chalfa, od shana trufa, asavim shotim malu bashvil uvagan. רוח נאנח את התריס פתח ומכה בקיר הישן כמו קורא הביתה, הביתה,
בעת לחזור מן הערים מסתוצרים היום דואך ואין סימן הביתה, הביתה תרם רדת אור לילות קרים, לילות מרים קרבים עכשיו לך עד עלות השחר מתפללת לשלומך שבויה באזיקי פחדים אני שומעת צעדים הביתה, הביתה כי עוד לא ניתן כל מה שהובטח לנו מזמן עוד שנה חלפה עוד שנה תרופה עשבים שותים עלו בשביל ובגן רוח ננח את הדריס פתח ומכה בקיר הישר כמו קורא הביתה הביתה באה עת לחזור מן הערים לשדות זרים היום דואך ואין סימן הביתה הביתה תרם רדת אור לילות קרים לילות מרים קרבים עכשיו לכאן עלות השחר מתפללת לשלומך שבויה באזיקי פחדים אני שומעת צעדים הביתה הביתה כי עוד לא ניתן כל מה שהוזך לנו מזמן.
Let's all rise. Aleinu, page 586.
Aleinu l'shabeach l'adon hakol, l'tet gilula l'yotzer breshit, shelo asanil kegoyer haratzon, ולא עשמנו משפחות האדמה שלא עשם חלקנו כהם וגור עלינו ככל המונם ואנחנו קוראים ומשתחווים ומודים לפני מלך מלכי המלכים HaKadosh Baruch Hu V'ne'emar V'haya Adonai L'melech al kol ha'aretz B'yom ha'hu B'yom ha'hu Yireh Adonai
Page 598, and we invite the mourners in our midst to please rise if you're able or raise a hand so that we can acknowledge you as a mourner and ask you to recite the names of those individuals you're remembering. I had Joni Braunwasser, Richard Budson, Joseph Chazen, David Graves, Michael Miller, Norman Raber, Charles Rosen, Abe Schwartz, Harvey Steinberg, and Suzanne Steer. And I've been asked to read the name of Pearl Marber, the mother of Renee Silva.
Let us all now rise, if you're able, in support of the mourners in our midst as they lead us in mourner's Kaddish. Yitzgadal v'yitkadash shemerabha v'yalma divra chirute v'yamlich malchute v'chayachon v'yomechon v'chaye d'cho beit Yisrael v'agala v'izman kariv imru amen. Yehe shmei rabam v'arach le'olam ome omaya Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitpa'ar v'yithromam v'yitnase v'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal shmeid grisha b'richu le'ela minko b'rchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechamata d'amiran v'yama v'imru amen. Yehe shlama rabba min shamaya v'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen. Ose shalom bimromav,
hu yase shalom,
amen v'yaho Yisrael. Ose shalom bimromav,
hu yase shalom aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'imru.
Skylar, if you'll come forward to lead us in Kiddush as you are about to become bar mitzvah in Israel. Soon, right?
Yes.
Do you know where you'll be standing when you're reading from the Torah?
The Western Wall.
The Western Wall. I can't think of a more amazing place than that. So, well, we'll be thinking of you. So we're so glad that you're allowing us to kind of celebrate with you and your family tonight as well. So will you lift that glass of juice high in the air and get us started? Can we get the text in front of everybody, Rabbi? Do we have one? Maybe not. All right, it's in the prayer book, page 123. You ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Baruch atah Eloheinu melech haolam barei peri hagafen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kiddushanu b'mitzvotav v'ratzavanu v'shabbat kodesho b'ahava uv'ratzon minchilanu zikaron lemaaseh bereshit ki hu yom techila Mikra Kodesh Zecher Letziat Mitzrayim Ki Vanu Vavarta Veotanu Kidashta Mikol Hamim Veshabbat Kodshecha Ve'ahava uv'ratzon hinchaltanu Baruch atah Adonai mekadesh ha-shabbat.
Amen. Take a sip, and we as a community can say to you, Mazel Tov. We know you're going to do a great job. Well
done.
Thank
you so much.
Before we go, we have a full weekend of programming with Gabi. So tomorrow, Jeff, help me out here. 3 o'clock tomorrow?
Go back.
3 o'clock Sunday. Say more.
If you go back.
It's all up on the screen.
Yay, perfect.
Would you look at that?
So where is it? Sunday, walk and talk with Gabi at 10. At Morris Pond, but then 4 o'clock. 3 o'clock or four?
4 o'clock.
4 o'clock, hybrid. So Gabi will be teaching. We hope you'll join us. I want to say mazel tov to everyone. Safe travels to Israel and mazel tov. We're going to say motzi, but before we do, unfortunately, Cantor Suffren was called away. I hope everything's okay. But I think it was Alexander Haig that said, I'm in charge now. Was that his line? So now that we don't have a concluding song from the cantor, let's all turn to page 625. It's not on the screen. Let's do Adonolam Asher Malah B'terem Ko Yitzir Nivra Li'et Nasa V'chefsako Azai Melech Shemoni Gra Be'achare Kichlotako Levado Yimloch Nora Behu Haya Behu Hove Behu Yiye Betifa
Last stanza.
Be'yado Afid Ruchi Be'eti Shan Me'ayira Be'im Ruchi Gevi'ati Adonai Li Ve'lo Yira. Together. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam Amotzi lechem min haaretz. B'teavon. Amen. Shabbat shalom. Good Shabbos, everybody.
Baby name it.